Hey, what's going on, everybody? SD here, and welcome back to another little more of NieR Automata. Yeah, again, I can't even talk this morning. Anyway, with that said, I've done a little bit since you guys last left off. Mainly, I've been focusing on upgrading 2B here, and we've actually, if you've noticed, switched back to the Twin Fang here. The Fang of Twins. I like the Twin Fang. But Fang of Twins. And the reason why is because we were able to upgrade that item. So let me kind of show you what we've done with that. If you notice, it's both of those are level 3. So the Fang of Twins is currently ranging attack as 868 to 896, which until I upgrade my Virtuous Treaty, which it will hit harder than the Fang of Twins. I'm going to use that currently. The reason why I like the Virtuous Treaty, though, is because it, for a large sword, it does hit really, really, really hard. So until we get the necessary upgrades for that sword, we'll be using good old Fang. The Fang. Let's see here. Aside from that, we also picked up a third pod. So what I ended up doing, go back to the old map. I went down to the flooded city since we currently have access to that. If you remember in the last video, we fought that big-ass robot in the middle of the city. And you can see the landscape here is really jacked up. So basically, this whole area right here has a big dent in it. It's like a crater. And this is the resistance camp. And what I did was I went over... in this location right here, and you go down, and it's like a little tunnel kind of leads into a sewer area, and I traveled back there and was jacking around and went over and started fishing. It's like a coastline area where you see a bunch of fallen buildings, and I ended up pulling up a third pod, which I currently have. Pods right here, which is a laser pod. So Pod A is our first one we got. Pod C was the second one we got. And then Pod B is the third one that I just picked up. So, and I've also applied a gravity because we got one of those from doing a side quest. Or I found it. I can't remember, to be honest. But anyway, we applied this gravity ability to that pod. So we got three different ones. These are the three that you have in a game. I don't think there are any other current ones that people know about. So that's pretty cool. And that's pretty much it. I've been running side missions, trying to take some of those out. There are a shitload of them in the game. A lot of them were just transversing back and forth, run here, run there. I mean, I literally spent probably about 5 hours just doing a handful of side missions because they take up, consume so much time. I enjoy sharing some of those with you guys, but I mean, God have mercy. If we record every side mission and the amount of time that it takes, I mean, we're going to hit who knows how many videos. So I'll do a few of those, I think. I believe I said in my last video that we would kind of wait and see on how we wanted to do that, and I just chose to do just a handful of them. I mean, hell, if you look at my quest, you can tell that I still got a fuckload of side missions that are still available that need to be done. Like this one right here is one that I was working on, and it's still there. I mean, it's just, again, it's a lot of back and forth. I mean, it kind of reminds me of the old Final Fantasy days where you're running back here, do this, do that, bring this back, or Zelda, do this. A lot of go get this, go do this, and then bring it back. So it takes a lot of time, especially when you don't fast travel the area. You have a lot of running back and forth, and that may turn some people off. I don't know. This one here, I actually tried a couple of times. It's kind of challenging. We may tackle that again at some point, but I will show these to you guys. I mean, some of them, if I feel that they're interesting, I'll go ahead and record them. The ones that are just boring as shit, I'm going to leave them out. So there's no point in recording that. Like this one right here is a lot of fucking back and forth of going and looking at certain areas that we've already been to, and I still have, it looks like, one more to go. And you got to take the coordinates to the guy in the resistance camp and go, here you go, buddy. Because apparently he lost his fucking memory or some shit. But anyway, and this one here, we're just waiting for Jackass to give us what we need. And I have no earthly idea how long that's going to fucking take. Okay, she's going to create some type of drug, but you got to give her some time. And trust me, we've given her 5 hours of time, and she hasn't done shit yet. Robo Dojo. I'd like to get this one finished up, and let me tell you, Father Servo is a son of a bitch. He's located in the city of ruins. It's not, I wouldn't know, I guess I'd call him a side quest, but he doesn't really move. He's on top of one of the buildings. You end up fighting him several times. And what you end up doing is giving him, like, stuff so that he can upgrade. And the process of doing that, Father Servo gets harder each time. Get out of here. So you can see how much damage I'm doing, that plus 601. So as Father Servo gets harder each time. The last time I faced him, I was a level 18, 19. And he was level 40, and it was probably one of the harder battles that I've had, including the bosses. It took me literally 20 to 30 minutes to beat him, and that was with my weapons that I have now. So, major son of a bitch. I was very under level at that point. Once I beat him, he opened up, and basically you got to go around to these dojos. Just to kind of explain that a little bit, and then you have to get him more materials in the process of doing so. You have to fight, you know, some more robots, and they can be quite challenging as well. I finally died, by the way, for the first time. I had so much pride in myself for not dying in this game yet, because I see dead bodies all over the place. And doing one of Father Servo's quests, one of those big-ass robots decided to plant a foot right on top of me. And for whatever reason, I just could not get out from underneath it. 2B was holding the foot up. I was obviously hitting the wrong button because I thought I could try to power out of it. And he flattened me like a pancake. So I was a little disappointed. I got one death to my name. I'll admit it. Anyway, enough ranting. Just wanted to get you guys caught up. I think what we're going to do on this video, the goal here is, if you notice the little destination marker, we're going to go down into this crater. We're going to see where this leads us and, I guess, go from there. I'm not exactly quite sure what that entails, to be honest. So, with that said, let's check it out. Well, dude trying to sneak up on me. This is a fantastic game. You could sit down and lose probably 2-3 hours easy. I mean, obviously, I sat down and for 5 hours and just doing side missions. Where in the hell are we going? Oh. Yeah, here's this huge crater that I was talking about. It's just absolutely huge. I'm gonna go down here, I'll show you.
That's a weird looking enemy.
That is a weird looking enemy. I don't know what that is. This is the tunnel I went through to get to the flooded city, if you're interested in that. So apparently we have to go down this way. Wow, looks like we can go all the way down there. But I don't know that that's the case. Wow, oh, he's already started. Let's see if we can take these dudes out. I have no idea. Since I have three pods now, we can hold down and I'll have three attacks. So here comes my third one. Oh. I fucked that up. Centipedes. I really wanted to show you guys that charge attack from my pods. This guy's a pain in the ass. There's the laser. Oh, these things are a fucking pain. Oh, shit. All right. I don't know if I need that to hit some freaking missiles. Break up third. So I got a good shot in there. Yeah, I haven't even been down to this area yet, so no idea what the hell's down here. I'll do some scavenging real quick. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed the content when I've been able to put out on this game. 2B, shut the hell up. I mean, 2B, 9S. If you guys have, just do me a favor, hit that like button for me and subscribe if you really enjoy the content, because I'm going to keep popping these games out as much as I can, the videos on these. So, and if you want, leave some comments for me. I do check those on a regular basis and comment back.
The ground is caved in. There must have been a hollow down there this whole time.
I'm gonna go over here and check this building real quick. As I was falling down into this area, I thought maybe we could access this building. No, I guess not. I thought you could get in there, but you cannot. Hey, it was worth a try, right? Like I've said it in one of my other videos, sometimes I never know what areas you can enter and what areas you can't. It's not always obvious. Make sure you do collect your material in this game. You will need it for upgrades for your weapons. I still haven't been able to upgrade my pods yet. I just have not had. What's this? Oh. Robo Dojo Black Belt. Did I? Hold up. That was the Black Belt? I guess those are what I was talking about earlier. I didn't realize. I thought they were just enemies down here. Okay. Quest. No, quest. Okay, so that's it? That's all. Hold on, we're not gonna go do this just yet. Let me get out of here. Let's see if I can go find Father Servo. So that may be the last item he needs. I may be completely lost in trying to find my way, so. Able to get up that way. There's the big ass robot that we fought too, which is right there. It's exactly good. This is exactly what I was saying about this game. I mean, it's like, man, you're off doing one thing and then it's so easy to get sidetracked because there's so much to do. Please do not fall. I don't feel like having to transverse this again. Alright, where the hell are you at, Father Servo? I guess it'd help if I checked my map, huh? Court, that's half wet. Okay, this is the city. City ruins near a tower. I think Father's over here somewhere, if I remember correctly, because this is off to the desert zone. At least he was, unless he moved. In any case, we're gonna go over here and see if I can find him. See what's on top of a building. I think I see on my map right there, the little dot. Yeah, he's right up there. So the only way I've been able to get to Father is to hop on this bus over here. God, I hope we get something good. I mean, this guy was an MF-er trying to face. There he is. You can see him on top of the tower over there. He starts out as this little robot. And then obviously he gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Let's see what he says. Silver, oh God. So we need silver ore, pristine screw, and a broken battery. Apparently I have none of those. Damn sure I didn't miss something down here. What's this? Hold up. Oh, body. I've been retrieving as many bodies as I can. What I found out was that you don't really obtain these items, even though it says obtain. And again, I may need to do a little bit more research because it sure the hell sounds like you get them. But my understanding is that you get those for a limited amount of time, like 30 seconds. It's just a boost. So as it pops up over there, it just says effect, effect, effect. So that doesn't stay with you. Okay, black belt. So did I get it? I feel like I'm really missing. Let me scavenge down here for a minute before we head on. You definitely get the money, and the money is good because you will need it. I don't see anything else down here. Still shows that I need. I can't click on that pristine screw. So I have silver ore, I have the broken battery, but I do not have the pristine screw. Okay. Wow, there's a lot of people that have died here. How the hell do you die right here? Did you fall off the side? I didn't want to repair you. Oh well. You come along for the magic carpet ride. I have two different areas to go. Light? Oh.
This hallway looks pretty old.
Oh shit. As you can see, they did not stand a chance. Got a pyramid head robot. Down this way. See, I always end up finding these places I can't
strong
go to.
Software locks detected. Access impossible.
I bet you this is the backside of what I was trying to get into in one of my other videos in the flooded city. It's a shortcut. You have to have 9S to open it. Just for shits and giggles, I'm going to go this way. Takes care of that now, doesn't it? Again, have to have a 9S. We can't open that. So there's only one way, my friends. One way and one way only.
Look at all these dead machines. Seems like they've been here for a long time.
Yeah, there are a lot of them. This looks like some type of alien ship.
What is this place?
I don't know. There's nothing like it in the database.
Uh-oh. Not good. Boss fight, I assume?
Are they dead?
To be.
We're about to find out, to be. It's a ball and chain,
destroyed
bitch.
Destroyed alien motherships.
See, look at that.
Welcome
alien.
To the graveyard of our creators.
Boss fight? Yes, it does appear that
you.
Way.
You,
to be, look out.
My name is Adam. The aliens you s-
yeah, screw you, Adam. I'm in the middle of retrieving some
shit.
Are
no longer here. They were wiped out centuries ago. By us.
Okay.
The machines.
Wiped out?
And who knows? Perhaps we'll wipe out the androids next. Machines are weapons capable of evolution. We can grow. We can become aware. Eventually, the intelligence within our network began to surpass that of our creators. You'd probably be surprised at how quickly it happened.
You destroyed your own creators?
Oh, there's no need to fret about them. They were simple, infantile, almost like plants, I guess you'd say. They held no value to us. But the humans on the moon? Now they are interesting.
Why them?
Because they are an enigma. They killed uncountable numbers of their own kind, and yet loved in equal measure. It's fascinating, don't you think? What could possibly drive such behavior? We have dedicated ourselves to unraveling this rhythm of humanity, and now we will allow you to assist us. You were made in their image, after all.
Assist you with what?
It's simple. We need you to locate the humans on the moon and bring them to us. We will then dissect and analyze them in order to drag their secrets forth into the light. Surely you see the attraction in this.
Are you insane? We'd never do that! Can you believe this, 2B? This guy's bonkers.
Well, I suppose this concludes negotiations. The only remaining option is to destroy you. The same way we destroyed these pathetic little aliens.
We got my guy down.
Time
halfway.
Grows short.
This year, this is the fate that befell our creators.
As for your beloved humans, I guess we'll see, won't we?
Oh. So let's kick their ass and they leave. They're gone. We'll be facing them again for sure.
The aliens were already dead.
Yeah. We better get back to the bunker.
What if there's some cool alien technology down here? Gonna slow your roll there, Mr. 9S. What's interesting is that... No, I thought I saw. It was just a glare. Damn.
Back this way again? What a pain.
Stop complaining.
Yeah.
Tubi, this is Operator 6-0. We now have an operational transporter in the city ruins. We're attempting to deploy them at other points as well.
About time we had access to those.
Care to fill me in?
Transporters? They let you transfer your consciousness to a temporary body back in the bunker. I heard some tech guys talking about it a while ago, but I didn't know they finally got it working.
Hold up, apparently I missed this. Let's see what they want.
Hey, how's it hanging?
You again.
Your commander told me to build a new access point, so here you go. Oh, and yeah, I got the stupid transporter up and running too.
Thank you?
I've known the commander for a while now. She sure is good at pawning work off on people. Next time you see her, give her some lip for me, will ya?
Give it to her yourself.
So this has a transporter now, huh?
Still, transporters are pretty handy. They're way faster than flight units when it comes to traveling between Earth and the bunker. Flight units also leave us open to attack, and they're expensive to operate, too.
Oh, so we've opened up fast travel. If I'm understanding correctly. Well, that's pretty badass. Didn't realize there was a ladder there. Let's check it out. Access point teleport. Beam me up, Scotty. And of course you gotta unlock them. It's like unlocking bonfires in Dark Souls. It makes sense. So. Oh, look at all the shit that I've opened up. Thank God. So they've done this like Dark Souls. The original Dark Souls, not 2 or 3. They've kind of copied the same mentality where you had to have the soul vessel before you could actually transport. So you had to progress a certain point into the game in order to do it, so very cool. I like it. So okay, desert camp, oil-filled housing complex, and we've been all over the place. I mean, hell, some of the side missions had me running back to the desert housing complex back and forth. So I guess we're headed to the bunker. This will probably make a good stopping point on this one. We got to face the twins. So let me get up to the bunker. Let's check that out real quick, see what's what. Tell you, man, this game is something else. I'm kind of glad I think the developers and the producer of the game actually did a decent job.
That concludes our report on the events surrounding the alien wreckage. Then they were dead this whole time.
The Council of Humanity needs time to formulate a plan. Until then, this information must be kept confidential. Speak of it to no one.
Of course. Your next mission is to gather additional intel on the individual known as Pascal.
You mean that freaky machine we ran into?
This order comes directly from the Council. Knowledge of such unique individuals is essential for the success of future missions.
Understood.
So, yeah, I think the developers and the producer actually did a good job because they planned this game right after the Ring City had come out, and they've given it, I think, enough time for people to actually beat that and then want something more. And this game, I feel like, kind of gives you that more. It kind of pacifies that desire to have that type of game. So, you've got mail.
Man, the commander sure is a slave driver, huh? And now we have to go back to the city ruins. Why don't we rest a little bit, 2B? It's been a while.
I'll rest if I feel like it.
You tell him, 2B. Let's see what we have in our inbox. What is this? Okay, some type of fish she wants me to eat. I bet she wants me to eat her fish. Yeah, we did go searching for him and he was looking for some chips. Operator 60.
This job can be pretty rough sometimes, huh?
We don't get to choose our assignments. And you should work on keeping your opinions in check. YoRHa aren't allowed to be emotional, remember?
I think some of us are better at that than others. Speaking of emotion, those Adam and Eve units sure seemed less than logical.
I'm heading to the transporter.
Fine.
Basically, I'm just roaming around at this point looking to see if there's anything of interest, so. So where are we transporting to? The desert camp? Let's transport there. Let's see if, is there anything of interest? Let's see what's going on with Jackass. Music in this game is pretty relaxing. I'm sure they have a soundtrack out for it. I wish they would have included it like a lot of some of the Dark Souls games will include a soundtrack. That'd have been nice.
Operator 60 to 2B. Be aware that the following transmission is classified Privilege Level 5. A group of YoRHa fighters deployed to the city ruins have deserted. We need you to take care of them immediately. But don't get yourself hurt, alright?
YoRHa members deserting? And attacking the Resistance, no less?
Proposal. Rogue YoRHa units should be captured and detained in order to keep collateral damage at a minimum.
Detained? Easy for you to say.
Oh, wow. She wants me to eat a fish that has a horrible effect. E-drug times 5. Whoa. Okay, that side mission's done. So what does that stuff do, I wonder? It's an enhancement item, I assume. No. E-drug. Disrupts auditory and visual feed for 30 seconds while generating other random effects. Well, okay. I still haven't ridden an animal yet. Anyway, good stopping point here. It looks like there's a lot of blips on my map that we have to go do. So, like I said, if you've enjoyed the content, please stay tuned to catch into the next episode. And until next time, you guys, peace out. I'll check you later.